Happy birthday to me. At least you remembered. Oh, hi, Josie. Hi, Sam. I'll try you again later. Hi, James. You missed my birthday party again. I'm sure you've got your reasons. Call me back when you get this. Do you even remember my name? Please say something. Say anything.
Trish!
Hi, my name is Sheena Strudick. I'm a nurse practitioner at Home-Based Primary Care in the VA. Today I'm going to talk about what it is to be a caregiver, the other perspective of from being a provider. This is my second time of being a caregiver. The first time it wasn't so bad because my mother lived outside of the country, so I was not there all the time. So the stress I did not feel at that time. However, this time I am the caregiver of my dad, who is 87 years old, who was originally independent up until earlier this year when he was in a car accident and fractured his hip. And it has been downhill since then. I do have a full-time job for which I'm responsible for a panel of patients. And in the afternoon, I go home and start all over again. There are many days I feel as if my Zeta burden scale is probably about 15 or 20. And it's not as if I have a psychologist or psychiatrist that I can go and talk to about this. But being a caregiver, you get a different perspective of what it's like, possibly for your patients. And it gives you a better understanding when they come to you and say, I am burnt out. It's only been a few months, but there are many days that I feel as if I have reached this point. I have to say thanks to my program manager who listens, who is my psychologist at time, who I can just go and speak with, who helps me through this process at times when I feel like giving up. But it's not an easy job, especially it's not only the patients that you're taking care of at this time and their family, but you have your loved one that you're taking care of. You have your siblings that you have to deal with. And at times they do not see eye to eye with what you're doing. And you have to start all over again as a provider and as a caregiver to explain to them what you're trying to do for your loved one who at this time is your relative. There are days when I feel like giving up. However, I have to remember I have patients depending on me. And on the flip side, I have my dad depending on me. So being a caregiver and being a provider, They're two different things, but the stress level of being a caregiver, I now understand what my patients are saying to me, and I understand what the families, the wives, the daughters, the sons, the husbands are saying to me, that I am burned out and I need some help.
We all have pain, we all have sorrow,
so Dr. Adu, what is the best advice that you can give a caregiver on how to take care of themselves?
Well, as a provider, I think that the most important advice I would give a caregiver would be to take care of themselves. I often take the cue from the airline industry. You know how you get on a plane, the flight attendants will come on the speaker and say to you, in case of sudden loss of cabin pressure, you know, the oxygen mask will drop down. Please make sure you put your mask on before you attempt to help somebody else with their mask. Obviously, if you pass out, you can't help anybody else. So as a caregiver, we all understand that there are prone to increased risk for stress, depression, exacerbations of any other medical illnesses like diabetes or high blood pressure and so things of that nature. And in addition to insomnia, you know, if you have someone who's a demented patient or a patient with dementia, you're up all night, right? Trying to make sure they don't wander or get away from from their room. And you want to make sure they don't fall. So you're up all night and you neglect yourself. So I think the best advice I would give a caregiver would be to make sure they take care of their own physical health and their own mental health as well. Maintain your social supports, you know, making sure that you keep in touch with other family members or your friends, making sure that you find some respite time for yourself or some quote unquote me time also is very, very important. Eat well, sleep well, and go see your own doctor also, because you really, really and truly can't take care of someone else if you yourself are ill also. That's the best advice I can give.
Thank you so much, Dr.
You're welcome.
Being a caregiver is a role that is universal. Caregiving has no boundaries and affects all demographics and socioeconomic classes. As you can see, not even the celebrities can escape the burden that may occur from caring for a loved one. I cannot stress enough the importance of self-care. You are no good to your loved one if you yourself are sick. You need to be at your absolute best to give the best care. We have reviewed the signs and symptoms of burnout and how to relieve stress. Remember, caregiving is not easy. You don't have to go at it alone. You just have to reach for a little help and receive help when it's offered. My question to you is, what will you do to take better care of yourself and your loved one? I am Lenitris Williams, your presenter of this webinar.